captain speaking. Please pay attention. Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, on behalf of Thomson Airways and my crew, a very warm welcome on board. I would ask that you please give me your full attention as I run through the safety procedure on board this aircraft. Your seatbelt must be fastened whenever the seatbelt signs are on. Your seatbelt is fastened, adjusted, and unfastened like this. We recommend that you keep your
hello, seatbelt. Hello, hello, hello! I see Paul Harris is in the house. Goldilabe, how's it all going? Tina Howard, thank you so much for tuning in. Everybody's in there. Robert Broca, how are you all doing? It's a Friday. Yeah, I hope you guys had a fantastic week. I for sure had a fantastic one. Tough Shimano, thank you so much, brother. And thank you so much for all the work that you've been doing behind the scenes. It's not going unnoticed. Johnny Norris, how's it going there, my man? Thank you all so much. All right, so today's topic is a fantastic one. I'm really, really excited about this. I'm going to talk to you about my experience of being an entrepreneur for the last 24 hours. All right, that's not as long as I've been on because there's no overnight success, but I've learned a whole lot in the last 24 hours than, all the courses out there and all the gurus out there can dare to say they can teach you. All right, so today we're going to be talking about 7 or 8 or 9 or 10, I don't know how long I'm going to go, just simple and powerful tips for people that are starting up in business, for people that are thinking of making entrepreneurship something of their own, especially if they think it's just a resolution you can make on the 1st of January and go on with it. It's not something for Christmas, it's not a New Year resolution, it's something you got to live, breathe, act, be, and really, really dedicate your whole life, your well-being, everything else that comes along with it. Randy, I see you're in the house. Bobby Williams, thank you so much for tuning in. All right, guys, let me just get the recitals out of the way. I mean, if I don't do this, then I don't get paid. All right, so basically, I believe that every one of you guys that's online right now should have a business that's profitable and enjoyable. And I also believe that as an online entrepreneur, you should have a business that you create for and you actually relate to the people that you're going to be demanding money off of. I also teach a 4-step simple system that is designed for coaches, small businesses like yours, so that you can brand market your services and have a business that's profitable and enjoyable. And I happen to lead a team of experts here at Live Long Digital that will help you grow your business essentially with digital marketing strategies. So I will help you curate and I'll help you, create an online footprint and optimize your business for growth and for profit. And that's the reason why every single day at 2 p.m. AEST, we sit around here for 30 minutes so we can discuss ways for you to earn money with less struggle. I'll also help you generate leads and revenue so that your business operates on autopilot. And I really, really want to inspire you to do the things that will inspire yourself. Now, everybody else that's just tuning in, thank you all so much. And I would like to congratulate every single one of you for surviving 2017 and you're still hanging on. Kudos to yourself. Congratulations, every single one of you guys. All right. So this is what it's all about. First of all, it's not easy. Second of all, you know it's not easy. And third of all, this thing is freaking hard, man. Being an entrepreneur, waking up, living life of your dreams, it's not what they sell you in those deceptive Facebook ads. You know what I mean? Starting a business can be a totally sensitive issue, especially for somebody who's aspiring or even somebody who started a long time ago. A lot of us are stubborn. The reason why we started our business is because we didn't want to take shit from nobody. All right? And what then happens is, most of us will also refuse to receive advice from other people or have other people helping us in our business because we want to go at it alone. All right? So I want to tell you guys, starting a company may be extremely hard, but if you get guidance, if you get people around you Do you know what I mean? If you get people that are going to support you, the beginning, and if you welcome that advice, you know what I mean? Just being stubborn and not actually listening to people that have been there and thinking that you, by yourself, you will succeed. I'm afraid it's not going to work like that. Why do you think that 10% of new startups or 10% of new businesses succeed? It's hard out there. It ain't easy. All right? Sean, how's it going, my man? Steven, thank you so much for tuning in. You see, everybody's out there doing the best they can. It's a fierce battle. You know, as soon as you leave the complexity or the comfort of having money from an employer, you're on your own, buddy. You are on your own. You know, we have a statement in our culture that says your goose is cooked. All right, it's hard out there. So everybody's doing the best that they can, and I really, really applaud you for the work you've put in already, for the effort that you've done, the networking you've done. Kudos to yourself. If you're happy with where you're at right now, just type in the number one so that I can also acknowledge you on the live, because you know what? It's not easy. It's just like when the veterans come back from battle or something like that, and they're congratulated, and then people say, thank you so much for your service. Type in the number one so that I can thank you for the service that you're doing out there, because entrepreneurs are making the world better. Entrepreneurs are putting food on people's tables if you employ people. Entrepreneurs are innovating the world. And you, my friend, Stephen Thompson, you're one of them. And especially what you do in your business to try and help people to actually feel better, do better, and be better with their bodies. You, my man, God has got a seat, or whatever deity you believe in has got a place for you, for your kind heart. Steven Siddon, I know you're doing well with your welding and helping other people at the sheds. You talked to me about that. Kudos to you for doing that, my man. Do you know what I mean? So every other new entrepreneur you will notice, or somebody who's just starting, or somebody who doesn't yet have skin in the game, you know, you should actually accept that you need help, so that you can get those results that other people are getting. We're here to live, we're here to learn, we're here to contribute. So as an entrepreneur, this is what happens. You live the life of maybe the 9-to-5 and you get tired of it. Then you start learning how you can make at least $1 online. But we learn from mistakes, right? You can't commit all the mistakes yourself. So you have to learn from other people's mistakes so that you don't have to go through those ones. You know? And learning from other people's experiences, that can be precious. Because the internet is a fickle thing, my friend. It's still a teenager, if you ask me. All this Facebook, all this Snapchat, all this Instagram, it wasn't there before. People were reading newspapers, now it's blogs. People were listening to the radio, now it's podcasts. People were listening to watching video on TV. Now we've got shows like this. When you learn what to expect and how to cope with any potential programs or any problems in your journey, because you've learned from other people, it will be easier for you to handle whatever comes your way. So if you're getting any advice, or if somebody's offering to mentor you, if you're stuck on something, seek out help. There's always people that are more than happy to want to be a part of what you're doing, to help you out, so that you too can be, do, and have a business that's profitable and enjoyable. Now, Robert says, I like that analogy. You can't make all the mistakes yourself, so no matter what, you need help. Exactly. So basically what you need as an entrepreneur, if you're not, you're not where you are because you don't know something. Because if you knew that little thing that other people know, you would be where you want to be. Right? You got to model behaviors or whatever it is that somebody who is in front of you has sort of, acquired or achieved. I meet and I come across a lot of people that are just tripping on themselves, thinking they're doing well. Just seek out for help. There's a lot of people out there that can help you out. You know? Basically, what you need to know is you need to be in control of what you're doing and where you get your education from, or what influences are coming in. Know what's happening inside your company and always try to stay objective. Some people don't even know what to look at, because we can see sinking ships from a mile away, but there's no way we can reach out because you're too stuck up in your business. Get out of the frame so that you can get to see the bigger picture. You know? Stephen says, just a question. Have you got a mentor? Bruh, I learn from everyone. And you know who my biggest mentor is right now? My biggest mentor is turning 3 in about 1 month. My little girl. I'm learning a lot from her. First of all, it's persistence. You can never say no to my little girl. You know what I mean? I'm learning from her every single day. I learn from you. The way you take action when I put something out there, Steve. I learn from just about anyone who's got something to say. You know why? You can't dispute where information comes from. You know? But sometimes some sources are not the best. You know what I mean? So you need to determine who you're learning from. So it will help you solve problems and catch them young. Catch them on in early stages so that they're not going to repeat themselves in the future. You know what I mean? So with that in mind, here are some tips that I want you to consider that would help you become some sort of a successful entrepreneur or do something different in 2018. Because what you tried to do this year has not worked. Because if it had, would have heard about you already. Alright? Capish? So there's some things that you might not know or some things that you might not have done this year. I want us to go in 2018 all guns blazing. I don't condone guns, by the way, but I know something. I know something for sure. I think it was Vince Lombardi that mentioned that the price of success is a lot of hard work. Dedication to the job at hand and also determination that whether we win or we lose, we have applied the best of ourselves to the task at hand. That was Vince Lombardi. I just drooped his quotation there, but I tried to remember it for things like that. First of all, 2017 may not have been your year for one reason. Yeah? And I know why. Because maybe you don't actually have a niche. Type in the comments there what your niche is. Who do you serve and why should they care to hear from you? What frustrations, what solutions are you actually giving to whom? And why should they care? Why should they even sit and stop eating their candy or playing Candy Crush or whatever it is that they're doing when your video comes online, when your blog is posted, when your status is put out there? Who do you help and why should they care to get it from you? Sibongile, how are you doing, my love? Thank you so much for tuning in. And Yong Zhang, thank you so much, brother. What is your niche? Who is your avatar? Because that's where the problem is. You know what the problem is these days? We were taught that you have to have an age range. So say your age range is from 26 to like 36 year old. I want to show you how wrong you are by thinking that that's the way to find your customer right now. Because a 26-year-old could be going to university and a 36-year-old could be a father of 4. All right? Now, what language do you speak to a university student and a father of 4 that combines them? Except that they're male. Do you know what I mean? Sandy Walker, how are you doing? I'm not ignoring you. All right? Do you see where the system is flawed? Because if you've got an age range of people that you talk to, their needs, their wants, and things that inspire them are totally different at that particular stage they are in their life. So maybe 2017 was not the best year because you did not actually define who your audience was. Who was meant to be listening to your word? Who was meant to be listening to your work? And who was meant to appreciate what you were doing? So maybe 2018, you really need to narrow it down, figure it out. Who are you serving? And why should they care? You know why? Because whatever you're going to be saying, they can always Google it. But why should they care to hear it from you? Why should you be sitting on this video right about now? Why would you not be doing anything else with your life right now? So who are they and why should they care? That's your new questions when you go into niche finding for 2018. In the beginning, every young, every sort of entrepreneur, you know, they get awfully frustrated. Thinking that they need to invent something new or revolutionary. You know what I mean? It doesn't work like that. Facebook has been invented. Uber has been invented. You don't have to come up with the new Uber. You just have to create and relate to the people that actually need what you've got. You know, there's no one that's literally going to take the world by storm. I mean, unless maybe there's a new technology that we haven't heard about. Because everything is just a reinvention right now. You know? So in reality, it's so far from true, from being true that you need to be, you know, revolutionary. You know? However small your idea may be, you know, you just need to focus on your target audience. Who really, really viscerally would believe what you say? Who would you justify their failures? Because whoever you're going to be going out for right now, whoever you're going to be going out for right now is already listening to somebody, is already buying stuff from somebody else. Why would they stop doing that and come purchasing from you? So you now need to focus on who your target audience is. Everything else that we probably were doing is flawed. Because if you're looking at an age range, I've just explained to you how totally different those people are. It could be a 26-year-old woman and a 36-year-old woman. All of those people are fighting different battles. The 36-year-old is probably fighting to get her second investment property. And the 26-year-old is probably just wanting to be on Tinder. Do they speak the same language? Do you think they comprende what you're saying? So you gotta have results. You gotta have gone through what it is that they want to aspire to. Now, aspiration marketing is important, my friends. Focus on who needs what you've got. Focus on who you can encourage their dreams. Confirm their suspicions because they've been duped already in the market. You're not going to be the first person that they're going to encounter. Align with their fears. Throw rocks at their enemies. Do you know what I mean? Thank you so much, Tina Wood. And I like what you talk about making women feel strong. But what age group? Who are they? And who is this woman? When you put out your content, is she on a tram or is she driving her Tesla? You need to know exactamundo who this person is. How do you understand? How does she understand you? What is it that you relate with her? Now you go out there and find those women that want to be strong. Because then that will be your niche. Other things will come later on, do you know what I mean? But for starters, this will do just fine. Figure out who can you help with what you've got. You know? That is going to be a social currency when you can actually say something and the pin drops and everybody can hear it. So much noise in the marketplace right now. So much. Yesterday, people were watching Gary Vee, all the stuff, and everybody's just going to continuously do everything that he said. You know, I'm not saying it's wrong, but you know what? There's too many copycats out there. What makes you stand out? What's going to make you shine in 2018? Adam A.E., thank you so much for tuning in, brother. And if you're really getting the vibe of where I'm going with this, please share this. For me, it's not a popularity contest anymore. I'm good. I just really viscerally believe that if you're working out there, you definitely should have a business that's profitable and enjoyable. And it's going to get harder and harder and harder and harder as we go in, because every person with a t-shirt and a pair of sweatpants is calling themselves an entrepreneur right now. How are you going to consolidate the sweat equity that you've put in the whole year right now in 2018? Grand opening, grand closing. Figure out who are you serving and why they should particularly hear it from you and nobody else. And like Steve asked me earlier on, he was saying that, who do I learn from? I learn from my little girl. And she has taught me not to take no for an answer. You know? In the world we live in right now, there's no place for sensitivity in the business world. There are no certificates for participating. You gotta be in it or you're not. Fit in or off. You know? So as a new entrepreneur, Chris, how are you doing? Thank you so much for tuning in. As a new entrepreneur in 2018, you've gotta be tough. You're gonna have to be tough. They are not giving participatory trophies. They are not giving participation certificates. You're gonna have to roll off the sleeves, get to work. If you're going to be out on the other end without any coal face, you're not putting in the work. You know? And you know, you may be facing a lot of rejections. There might be obstacles along the way. The important thing is to choose your battles wisely. Not everyone is your customer. So when you really, really know who you're going out for, figure out how can I create and relate to those people. You know? And those things that are not working for you, ditch those things. You're not meant to be doing everything. Figure out what are you good at and who are you actually serving and who needs to hear it from you. That's how you're going to win in 2018. You know? And if things are not working, ditch that dodo. Figure out what is actually working. But I'm not saying jump on and jump off onto different things, etc., etc. You know? When it comes to things that really matter, you should never back down. So don't be taking no for an answer in 2018. All right? And one other thing about 2018, if you're going to be new or if you're going to be rebranding or revamping yourself, communication and cooperation are the next best thing. You're here to live, you're here to learn, you're here to serve. How are you going to communicate your participation in the grand scheme of things in society? Why should people actually care? You know? Who are you communicating to? Are they actually understanding? Are you creating relationships with people that can, you know, put you in front of, you know, your clients? Are you, or people that can supply you with the goods that you need? You know, in order for your business to thrive, especially in 2018, it's essential to establish some really strong and positive culture around your business from the get-go. Relations with people that are going to be supplying you with business, whatever goods you need. And if you're going to be employing people, there has to be transparency and communication. Because you can't hide anything these days. Everything that you do, say, or choose to be is on social media. You know? Show people you actually care about them. Show your customers that you actually care about them. Show your appreciation for them affording you the lifestyle that you're going to be having. It's no longer a matter of you just receiving money and bye-bye, see you later. No. People now want to be appreciated. If somebody rings you, pick up the phone as if they're the only customer you have. And if you're a well-functioning business, because the people that you're targeting, you know them, you might as well be liking them, you know? And show mutual respect to those people that are going to be affording you that lifestyle. This whole, I'll just give you a product and end of transaction. If that's how you've been doing it in 2017, I'm afraid it might not work for you in 2018. And I stand to come back to this video again and see if people would think that I was wrong in my predictions. All right? Emotional intelligence is now better than IQ. All right? EQ is now ways better than your IQ. It's not about what certification or whatever it is you've got. Do you care? Do you have the goods? Luke Corin, man, how's it going, my brother? Are you actually respecting the people that are affording you that lifestyle? Do you actually know your duties? Then nothing will stop you in your way to success. You know? Another thing that might be, you know, facing a lot of entrepreneurs right now is they're too rigid in their way of thinking. There's no more time for people to wait for you until you get it. You have to start being very flexible and accommodative with whoever you're going to be working with people, you know? In the long term, the more flexible you are, the better people would get to understand what it is you've got to offer. Do you know what I mean? So, I don't know. How's it all going so far? Everybody's quiet today. Or am I just preaching to an empty theater? How's the Friday going? All right. So then, whatever it is that you're going to be doing, just like what I think it's Mark Zuckerberg says, fail fast and fail often. Always be learning, guys. You know, people are afraid of failure. But it's really, really important to remember that failing is normal. That's how you learn. We're here to live, we're here to learn, we're here to contribute. You know? Do you know what I mean? Failing is normal. So don't you ever think that if you fail this year, 2018 is not going to be your year. Everyone fails, and it can be avoided, or you can choose what to learn from it. You know? What you can do. I mean, it doesn't mean, you know, all the successful people haven't failed. But it's what you do and how you choose to cope with it. So if 2017 has not been your year, sit back, regroup, and go in. Figure out what went wrong. You know? Figure out what went wrong. Instead of mopping around, feeling sorry for yourself, go in. And just don't commit the same mistakes. Because then you've got an opportunity to learn and improve. And try to do that as soon as you realize that this is not working in order for you to live with minimum consequences. And guess what? Be grateful of all your failures because they are your best teachers. I always say you're here to live, you're here to learn, you're here to contribute. And when you learn, you're learning from mistakes, but you're also learning from other people's mistakes. So figure out what you want to learn real quick. Take the lessons from them and keep learning. Because I want to tell you something. Those people that, you know, those people that were entrepreneurs in the last 10 years, because every 15 years, there's a change, there's a shift in society. There's a shift in communities. You know why? Because those 15-year-olds are now teenagers and they're now thinking on their own and they're bringing in new ideas into a community. So what used to happen is, you know, people would just stick to what they know. Keep learning these days. The internet is a fickle place. It's like quicksand. What worked for that guru 2 years ago is not going to work for you next year. That's the reason why a lot of people are failing. Because, yes, you can model their success, but have you got the same room they have that makes you concentrate on your work? Have you got the same spouse that goes and buys food and cleans the house while you're concentrating on work? Have you got the same inspiration? Have you got the same hours of the day that they have? Do you, my friend? Figure out, you gotta start knowing who you are as a person. You gotta start knowing yourself. Because once you know yourself, then you know when to take away the thoughts that are happening in your head. Because apparently 90% of the thoughts that happen in our head are all fear or love. Those are the only two driving forces. If you're not loving anything, you're fearing it. So figure out where exactly are you in the whole grand scheme of things. Keep learning. First of all, learn who you are. And then learn how you can implement the things that you've learned from other people. The most important remark is related to constant learning. What the internet was yesterday, totally different. But you still are the same person. So why would you not rather learn the constant? Learn and focus on things that don't change, which happens to be. The internet can change totally. Today it would probably be a new interface, new way of doing things. But you still there. Because you're the star player of this whole show, aren't you? Even when it's all starting to go on well, and you're just tucking into your comfort zone, snap out of it. Because those that stay in the comfort zone are left. Used to bees don't make any honey. I can see and I can tell a lot of people that used to be in this whole niche. Now they're crying. You know? It's a trap. Once you get to another level, there's another devil. And just like when you're playing video games. You know that you're going forward when you're meeting a lot of, you know, dangers or a lot of devils. If you stay in the one place, the game stops. You know? So that's why I'm saying you have to be tough. Mental toughness. You know, a lot of people you lose control if you stop trying. Have you ever tried to be on a bicycle and you're just standing on it like this? You know, you get momentum by pedaling. So to be a successful entrepreneur involves constant self-improvement and learning and tweaking your perspective. Get involved with different people. You know? There's no taking breaks with your mind operates 24/7. You might as well feed it with important stuff that would be helping you when you're not operating at full capacity. Read books. Please do at least one book a month. You know, educate yourself online. Keep up with some trends, but I'm not saying follow, you know, there's two confusing notions around here. I'm not saying follow all the, what do they call them? I'm not saying follow all the shiny objects, but I'm just saying stay relevant. One of the biggest hazards in businesses is they think what they think is how they're going to succeed. Oh yeah, we used to be good. Oh yeah, last year these were our numbers. Somebody right now is working twice as hard to get half of what you have. Now can you imagine how much they're working? Twice as hard just to get half of what you have. There's always dangers lurking around the corner. If you stop, you get eaten. Especially for the one that's starting, especially for the entrepreneur that's starting. And those that are already, you know, complacent and thinking, oh yeah, we used to be, that's how it is. Used to bees don't make no honey, my friend. But I'm not here to stay you. I'm not here to scare you. I actually care about you, man. Give us a virtual high five. And if you've given me a virtual high five, just type in the number one there. I want you to be always aware of your goals. I want you to be always ready to try as hard as you can to achieve them. We're getting into a new year now. New beginnings. New everything else. You really gotta go in with oomph. You know what I mean? Do you know the word triumph? Right? If you try, it's alright. But if you put a bit of oomph, you triumph. Triumph. Alright? So don't lose your initial enthusiasm and your motivation. Be persistent like a mofo. Alright? Have faith in yourself. Because what you're about to create never existed before you came onto this world. And that's how winning is done. Alright? I hope this is going to be the guide for you even in the darkest of times. Come back to this video whenever you feel down and under. And if you really feel like today has been a showdown, please share this video. Alright? This is going to be the last video for this week. Because obviously we don't go live during the weekend. But I viscerally believe that you've got greatness inside of you. You know? And if you've made it to the end of this video, please share this. Because I believe that your business is supposed to be profitable and you're meant to enjoy working in it. Let's see the coal face. Alright? I know that all you can do is all you can do. Like go out there and make the best of it. Alright? Here's to a 2018 for you and everything else that comes along with your business. Alright? Good on you guys. This is only the beginning and we're only just getting started. Alright? Thank you so much for tuning in, guys, and hope you're going to have a fantastic weekend. I viscerally would like to see you guys championing your businesses and getting results there. Maybe 2017 was just practice. 2018, that's the main event. Let's go out there and get them, guys.